destruction of fertility, new lifestyle. We are seeing a very disturbing phenomenon of a sharp drop in the number of births, especially in industrialized countries. Europe is become a dying continent. More women do not want to have children at all, or at most one. And fertility is a social disease. Life without fertility. The social norm becomes a life without fertility. In EU countries, the vast majority of young people destroy their fertility, treating it as a normal lifestyle. Contraceptives, especially based on steroid hormones, flood the pharmaceutical market and are sold in millions. Steroids occur in wastewater, water and food. Number of infertile couples is increasing. Non-effective treatment widely available for the treatment of disturbed menstrual cycle, most commonly contraceptives are used. A child becomes a sought-after commodity and a lot of money can be made on which you can order using a procedure called in vitro, which are widely advertised. You can order now even a child with certain characteristics of gender. The number of human embryos dying during the procedure are stored in liquid nitrogen reaches millions. Abortion, the killing of unborn children, is famously promoted as the right of women. It is not politically correct to talk about the negative consequences, such as lack of fertility.
She gave up this time. It is a way of thinking, a lifestyle accepting deliberate destruction of fertility. Its main goal is to see the child's conception as a total threat against which one must furiously defend yourself. That leads to the deliberate destruction of fertility through pharmaceutical or other contraceptive means. Negation of a child and use of contraception leads first to sexual freedom and consequently to the acceptance of early abortions, which is still popularly called contraception. Human life begins with the mother's ovum, which is fertilized by the father's sperm. The use of anti-implantation means and the killing of unborn children in the first 2 weeks of life, from the moral point of view, is no different from the later abortions. As a result, contraceptive mentality leads to the acceptance of abortion.
Mental blocking of fertility. It is known that female fertility is largely dependent on the correct hormonal changes during the menstrual cycle. Its control is based on the correct operation of the pituitary gland. In short, everything depends on health. If so, for many years she lived with the awareness of deeply accounted infertility and the fear of conceiving a child, which in turn caused permanent change, these experiences are taken deep into the subconscious, strongly influencing the vegetative system, which in turn caused permanent changes in the female body, and can affect the menstrual cycle, which is responsible for the regularity of the appearance of fertility. After many years of living with negated fertility, it often happens that it not can be easily restored. Infertility is becoming more and more frequent social disease. Against the child. working 25 years in family counseling and teaching young people so-called natural methods, we realize that today most young people express an interest in learning to recognize their fertility in order to avoid it. Contraceptive thinking has become so popular that it is also transferred on methods. The only incentive for selection of these methods is ecological motivation. Nothing will be destroyed. It is cheaper and healthier, but absolutely no child. This is system of thinking. The child is still seen as a serious threat and its appearance is scary. One of my colleagues, who is a teacher of natural fertility awareness, had a patient who brought her a bouquet of flowers. She stated that she is very grateful because knowledge of the natural method allowed her to recognize her pregnancy in a very beginning and quickly perform a very early abortion. Without such serious consequences to health that is caused by later abortions. My friend was shocked. Child died and the knowledge was used against it. She realized that before teaching any method, you first need to devote adequate time for psychological therapy for removing the fear of having a baby. This can be done using simple methods of psychology. Sometimes change of attitude is rapid. Sometimes it takes a long of time. Recognition of fertility. Modern science offers an easy and non-initiative and non-invasive way to complementarily identify fertility. In short, a woman can really know when she is fertile and when she is not. You only need to want and learn. It should be noted, however, that there is no such thing as natural contraception. This expression is contradictory in itself, because contraception is never natural. Teaching natural methods on fertility recognition must be based on acceptance of fertility. If the child is a precious value and is loved, you sacrifice a lot for him. Then responsibility, restraint, effort, and significance of the choices make gain sense. Living with fertility becomes a challenge, but also a lifestyle that brings much joy and satisfaction. Conscious choice of fertility. Reliable knowledge gives us the freedom to make informed choices. When a young man wants to drive a car, must pass a driving test to be able to safely move on the roads. Meanwhile, in the procreation area, young person usually is deprived of this knowledge completely. They only learn how to destroy their fertility and their children. We can say that today young people do not know how to make children. They believe that they know how, but totally don't know when. A child can be conceived only in the specific time, which is relatively short. Recognizing their own fertility and overcoming the fear of a child gives a person freedom and possibility of an informed choice. Opening up oneself to fertility. The removal of fear opens the human heart and gives freedom. Spouses who know and use natural methods of fertility recognition are more open to life. Potential child is accepted and loved. And when it is conceived, there is no dilemma what to do with it. Abortion, general, is not an option. Parents who use natural methods are often accused to more children, insinuating that the reason is the ineffectiveness of these methods. This is one of the myths promoted by contraceptive mentality. Properly used, natural methods are very effective, as confirmed by research of many scientific centers. They have more children because they overcome and fear the fear and are open to fertility. They are more aware to their choices, and they have more children because they want to. Fertility is a gift from God. Fertility is a gift from God, a giver of life. Despite of great efforts and huge funds, men cannot alone create a new life. We can only manipulate and destroy what has already arose. God entrusts and the great gift of new life is in our hands. This can be compared to a situation where a guest is coming to our house, gives a beautiful bouquet of flowers. What then we do with it? We think with a smile. And we put the flowers to the vase and water to keep them exposed and enjoy them. But how would the guest feel if we would, in front of his eyes, destroy the flowers and then throw it to the trash? He would be very offended. You may even expect a violent reaction. But God is very patient. Give us new life and is consistent. But we should not forget that he will reclaim the blood of his smallest and most defenseless. Today, when so many people destroy their fertility and reject his wonderful gift, he says, "What you do not want, it's not." Infertility is a social disease. More and more marriage do not have children. Society begins to die. Thank you very much.